Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial I want to show you how goals work inside ActiveCampaign. So goals actually like really handy features. You can use them for a couple of different things. So let's dive right in. So first of all, what are goals, right? Now, simply said, it's an action that you can add to your automations to do something. So if you go over to an automation and you click this little plus, that allows you to add a new action. And then underneath conditions and workflow, you will find goals. Now, goals can be used for a couple of different things, but these are the two main purposes. So either you use it to measure the effectiveness of your automation, or you use it to move context to a different position inside an automation. So what I want to do, first of all, explain a little bit more about settings inside the goal, and then I want to show you these four examples. So how you can exit a promotion when somebody is purchasing, well, how you can like add a not interested link to your emails so that these people will automatically exit the automation, how you can resend emails only to people who did not open them, and how you can measure a percentage that converts, and how can you also see how long it takes them. So first, a little bit more about that goal. So when you add it to your automation, you see like a few settings. So you can obviously give it like a name, did something we want. And then you can also add conditions to that goal. So a goal is basically a thing where people jump to when they meet these conditions. So you can just set those here. So either when they get like a certain tag, like here when a tag equals this, or when a tag is removed, or when they entered a certain automation, or when they visited a certain page on your website. It can basically be anything, whatever you want to make people jump over there. So in this little example, I want to have a tag, and then if they purchased my product, in this case, I want people to jump over there. Now then you have another setting that says, okay, when should this goal trigger? So only when the goal is below the context position or anywhere. So that means that when you have your goal inside an automation and the person is still above that goal inside the automation, then it will jump there. If the context is basically already below the goal inside your automation, and I'll also show you some examples of that in a bit, then you will not jump there when it's set to this. But when you set it to anywhere, then it doesn't matter where that context is inside your automation. So sometimes you only want people that when they're still above the goal to jump there, and sometimes just anywhere. Now, in this case, I will leave it to below context position. And then if you want, you can also trigger a conversion when this goal is achieved. So when you go into settings of ActiveCampaign, you can like set a bunch of different conversions. So I, for example, here have one that's called completed onboarding. And if you want, you can trigger that, but just keep in mind that this is only available on like higher tier plans inside ActiveCampaign. This is not included in the light version, but honestly, I'm also not really using this. So right now I just leave it to none. And then what do you want to do with people that are like in your automation and then naturally go into your goal? So maybe they did not like require or like meet these conditions, but they went there anyway. So what do you want to do with those people? Do you want to continue the automation as it is, or do you want to wait until these conditions are met, or do you just want to end the automation for those people? That's also possible. So yeah, these are basically all the goal settings that you can do. So it's actually not too hard, right? So yeah, the examples that I want to show you, I want to start with these two first. So first, I want to show you how you can like have like an automation for maybe a 3-day promotion, and then how you can exit that. And also in the same automation, I want to show you how you can include a link that people can click inside the email so that they will not be bothered about that promotion anymore. So this is what that automation looks like. If you want to import this, then I'll also put a link to it in the description below, just so you know. But like how it works is like this. People get an email like, hey, the promotion is upcoming, whatever, it starts tomorrow. And then we trigger a hook from deadline funnel to start the deadline. And then we simply send an email like, hey, the promotion is starting today. The day after, we maybe send like a cool story or a valuable email. It doesn't really matter what you do there. And then on the last day, we remind them, we say like, hey, this is the last day the offer is valid. In the afternoon, we send another email that says like, hey, your questions are answered. And then in the very last email in the evening, we can send them something like, hey, last chance. So it's not too much about how you set this up, but more about, okay, how do you exit the automation as soon as someone purchases your product? Because it's a bit annoying if somebody would like purchase your product or maybe your services after this email, and they will still get all these follow-up emails, right? We really do not want that. So to do that, and you already see it here, we add a goal, and the name of the goal is purchased offer. So when someone is purchasing the offer, we just skip all the emails, and then boom, this person goes to the end of the automation right away, and then we end the automation. So this is how I have set it up. So the name is purchased offer, and then these are the conditions that have to be met when a person jumps over there. So I set up two different conditions. So one is that the tag exists, sales purchase funnels that convert. So with my like shopping cart software, ThriveCart, I can automatically add a tag to everyone who purchases a certain product. And then I also use that in combination with my membership site to like give people access to that product. And, or I should say, or when someone visited the confirmed page. So I did that because I noticed that sometimes people purchase the product with a different email address, and then it would still be inside this automation. But when I use ActiveCampaign, their site tracking, then I can, and I also know like, okay, hey, cool, this person purchased this product, so I should exit this automation for that person. So that's how you do that. So you just have like a simple goal for everyone who has that tag or visited the confirmed page. Now, then I also wanted to give people the option to like basically opt out of the promotion. So maybe they still want to receive my emails, but they do not really want to know anything about this promotion. And I think that's totally fine. So to do that, you have to include a special link inside your emails. So I will show you this email. Let me edit it, and then I can show you what basically the unsubscribe link looks like. All right, so as you see here in the end, I added this little block. So if people want to go completely off the list, they can just click that link. But if people are just not interested in this, then they can click this link. And this link is nothing special. It's just like a trigger link with a page on my website that I use for a bunch of different things. It looks like this. It just says, oh, no problemo. I won't bother you about this anymore. Picture of me. And then, yeah, some call to action, like take me to the blog that I can maybe like read an article or whatever. But this link allows us to measure link clicks inside ActiveCampaign. Because ActiveCampaign automatically measures what everyone is clicking. And then with this call that I called not interested, we check if someone has clicked the link inside this email. And then you see here that the link is that not interested link. And then I set it up for every email. So as soon as someone clicks the not interested link inside one of the emails, they will automatically jump to this goal, and then they will exit the automation. And I think this is actually one of my favorite use cases, so that people are not going to unsubscribe, but that they can just like be like, ah, you know, like I love your content, but like this is not for me. And I think that's totally okay, right? So that's a cool use case. Then I want to show you how you can skip resending emails if they are not opened. So we sent an email and we resend the email 2 days later if they didn't open something. So this is my evergreen newsletter. I also created a whole tutorial about this in case you're interested. But it works like this. We send our emails, for example, this one, what I want for you plus a cool gift. Then we wait for 2 days and then we resend the same email with a different subject, right? But we do not want to resend the email in case someone opened the first email. So what I did, I included a goal that said opened email. So in this goal, I check if this person opened the first email. So then if yes, this person will jump from here over here, and then the resend email will not be sent. Now, and this for us, for example, also why it's important to set this right. So here you see it's set to below contact position. So when the person is over here, the contact, then it can jump over there. But when it's already here and it opens then an old email, it's not just jumping over there. Well, if you would then set it to anywhere, then even if that person is over here and opens an old email, will jump right back. So you really do not want that. So that's another really cool use case. You can also do it with an if else, but I think especially for like really long automations, then this is just like a really neat way to do it basically. So that's the third use case. And then the last one that I want to show you is that you can also use a goal to like measure what percentage is converting and also how long it takes. So you can basically use it for like all kinds of different things. But here is a little example that I want to show you. So I have an automation that I call the permission bridge. So basically everyone who joins my list, I do not want to like spam the crap out of them right away, or like I do not want to spam the crap out of anyone, but like I only want to send emails to people who actually gave explicit consent, like, hey, I would love to have your emails. Like I do not just want to bother people. So I have this like little automation. I can maybe also show you. And in that automation, I send an email to people asking, would you like to receive more emails from me? You see that here. It's called want more tips. And then I basically just wait until they reply. When they reply, they jump to this goal that says has replied. And then I give them like a tag that says like, okay, this person gave consent to receive emails. And what is so cool here is that in this goal, you can exactly see how many people did that and also how many people already gave consent. Because I also have forms on my website where there's like a checkbox that says like, hey, I want to receive more, or I'm using Facebook Messenger bots, and then I just use ask it inside the Facebook Messenger bot. Or some opt-in forms are more like, hey, join the list and get your checklist or whatever, and then they already gave their consent. So here you see that from all the contacts that go into this automation, 59.3% already gave consent, and then 7.7% of the other people basically replied. So that's like 1/5 of the people that not gave consent already like replied to that. And then when I click this has replied, you can even see more data about it. So let me click this. So I will blur all these personal details here, but I guess you can still get it. So here you see how your goal is performing. Like if you have like multiple goals, then you can compare which one is working best. In this case, that doesn't matter. And then you can also see the completion rate. So 7.7% of all the contacts like completes this thing. And then you can also see if there is any increase or decrease in the last 30 days. So it's maybe cool if you change something in the automation that you can see like, hey, does it have any effect? And then what I also think is interesting is that you can see how long it takes on average for people to complete that goal. So in this case, I asked them to reply. How long does it take on average for people to reply? So I think that's pretty interesting. And then if you want, you can also filter all the contacts below that I blurred right here, but like you get it anyway. You can like, for example, here filter them to everyone who completed it or did not complete it. And then you can maybe also do something with those contacts. But I think this is pretty cool, right? So I hope that this helped you to understand how goals work inside ActiveCampaign. They're actually not too tricky, but I think as soon as you have seen some examples, you just know what is possible. So the next tutorial is about how you can use ActiveCampaign tags, because tags also often work together with goals. So be sure to watch that tutorial. You see it on screen right now. And if you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a little thumbs up. And if you have any questions or just want to say hi, then just please comment below. All right, see you in the next video.